Hello everyone. So the topic that we are going to discuss today is public deposit. Okay, so public deposits are referred to the unsecured deposit. Why is it called an unsecured deposit? Because there are no collaterals involved in public deposit. When the companies offer the public to deposit in their organization or company, they do not fix any asset to those deposits. Okay, these are the unsecured deposits for a short period of time to finance their working capital needs or inventory needs. Okay, so this deposit is for short period of time. Any member of the public can fill up the prescribed form and deposit the money in with the company. So all that has to be done is just to fill up the form that is given out by the companies to deposit in their company. The rate of interest on public deposit depends on the period of deposit, that is how long you are depositing the money, and the reputation of the company. So higher the reputation of the company, higher will be the interest rate on the public deposit. A company can invite public deposit for a period of 6 months to 3 years. So it is a short term debt. Okay, next is companies prefer public deposit. Why do companies prefer public deposit over bank loans? Is because public deposits are cheaper than bank loans. Whatever interest they have to pay on bank loans, it is higher than whatever interest they have to pay on public deposits. The public prefers to deposit money with the well-established companies because the rate of interest on public deposit is higher than on bank. So whatever interest the public will get from the public deposit, it will be higher than if they put their money in the bank. Okay. Next, merits of public deposit: simplicity. Nothing has to be done, only a form has to be filled in, wherein whatever the form has been given by the company to deposit money, only that form has to be filled in, and there are no cumbersome legal formalities. Okay. Economy: how is public deposit economical to the companies? First of all, that the interest rate is lower than the bank loans. Okay, like we discussed earlier, and there are no flotation costs. So there are no underwriting cost, there are no brokerage cost. Okay, so there are no such things like issuing the equity shares and preference shares. Okay, no charge on assets, that is public deposits are unsecured deposits, and therefore there is no charge on assets. So if the people do not get their money back, the principal and the interest, they cannot touch the assets of the organization. Flexibility: so whenever the organization needs money, they can raise public deposits. So suppose they want to buy raw materials, they can raise money through public deposits. Okay, next is trading on equity. Trading on equity, because public deposits has to pay interest rate, and these interest rates are tax deductible, and therefore if the ROI, the return on investment, is more than the interest rate of public deposit, then more the public deposit the organization inculcates in its capital structure, higher will be the earning per share. That is trading on equity. I have made a separate video for trading on equity. It is a very long and important concept. You can go and watch that video. No dilution of control. So if the public, if the company is issuing public deposit, there is no dilution of control like in equity shares. So because the people holding the certificate of public deposit do not become the owners of the company, neither do they get any voting rights. Wide contact: public deposits enable a company to build up contacts with the wider public, which will help them further to be able to issue shares and debentures in future. Okay, now let's do some demerits of public deposit. Uncertainty: because whenever suppose the organization requires to finance their working capital, it is not certain that if they offer public deposit, at that time people will be able to invest in public deposit, because the depositors may not respond when economic conditions are uncertain. So if there is a high risk of in economic condition, there is a depression going on or there is recession, the public is not interested in depositing their money in public deposit. Okay, and moreover, they can withdraw their money whenever they want to by giving a prior notice. So, if a large number of depositors simultaneously withdraw their money, it becomes a financial burden for the organization to give this high amount of money at one single time when there is a difficult time going on in the organization. Okay, so you cannot depend on public deposits for financing your working capital. Limited funds, a larger amount of funds cannot be issued through public deposit. There is a limited fund that can be issued, and that's why you cannot just depend on public deposits for your finances. You have to take in other sources also. Public deposit will be the public's deposit will be able to finance only a limited amount of fund. Temporary finance, so unlike equity shareholders shares, the public deposit has to be repaid because it is redeemable, and that's why it is not a permanent finance. It has to be repaid when the maturity period has been attained. Limited appeal of public deposit, how? Because bold investors who want capital gains would not invest in public deposit because there are no capital gains in public deposit. Capital gains can be attained through equity shares. Okay, conservative investors may also not be the public deposit may also not appeal conservative investors because it is an unsecured deposit. Okay, unsuitable for new concerns because the new businesses do not have a strong credit standing, and that's why people are not interested in investing money in such organizations which do not have strong credit standing. On the other hand, it is also unsecured, and that's why public would not want to invest in new businesses which do not have a strong credit standing. So public deposit is similar to debentures. Now the question comes, what is the difference between public deposits and debentures? Because on debentures also we have to pay interest, on public deposit also we have to pay interest. On debentures also the interest rate is tax deductible. On public deposit also the interest rate is tax deductible. So the first difference between public deposit and debentures is that debentures are permanent source of finance. They are there for the or to with the organization for a longer period of time, and public deposit is there for short period of time just to finance the working capital of the organization. Okay, and debentures are transferable in nature. So if I have bought a debenture, I can transfer that debenture to another person. Then that person becomes the owner of the debentures. On the other hand, public deposit does not have this transferability option. So if I have bought public deposit, that public deposit will remain in my name forever. I cannot transfer that public deposit to anyone else. So this is about public deposit.